Good afternoon, Key Stage 2, and welcome to your final online assembly of the year, and hopefully your final online assembly for a very long time. I will talk a little bit more about plans for next year later on in assembly, but I'm going to start off as usual by going over to some of your teachers for their pupils of the week. Over to you, teachers.
Good afternoon, everyone. Before I announce the pupil of the week, I would like to just say congratulations to all of Year 5 who have been on Edmodo for this past 12 weeks. The work that you've submitted has been great, and it has, in fact, been preparing you for your transition into Year 6. So well done to all of you. You really do deserve a break. The pupil of the week this week, I'm going to award it to Varsha, because she's another person on my long list of dedicated children during this period of distant learning. She consistently submitted work of a good quality. She responded to messages, made corrections, and overall, her work has been very good. So congratulations to you, Varsha. You are the last pupil of the week, last but not least, and I know you know that. So I think the last thing to say then is happy holidays, everyone. Enjoy your time away from Edmodo. Keep safe. Have a great holiday. And I hope to see you all again at the end of August. Take care. Goodbye.
Hello, 3S, for the final time this year. I hope you've had a really good week. And I really wanted to thank you for being such a wonderful class this year. I have really, really loved being your teacher. You are all, every single one of you, so kind, so caring, and so polite to each other. You're also very hardworking, and I know how much you all love a challenge. So well done for all your brilliant work this year. I really will miss you next year, but I look forward to watching you grow with your new teacher. We also have to say goodbye today to Nelson, because he is leaving Isimilo this summer. So we want to wish Nelson lots of luck in his new school in the UK and his new life over there. And as you all know, in 3S, we've been working on something quite special for Nelson, so I'm sure he will see that soon. So my last star of the week this week is going to someone who has just really entertained me during this time of distance learning using Edmodo. He works really hard in all of his work, but it is his videos that make me laugh the most. He's a real entertainer, and I'm sure you would agree. So well done to Bill. Bill, thank you for making me laugh every time you send me one of your funny videos doing your work. Keep up the amazing work. I hope you all have a lovely, lovely summer. Make sure you stay healthy, you rest, you relax, and most importantly, you have fun. And I will see you in September. Bye!
Hello everyone, and welcome to the last start of the week for 3A. So this week, my dogs Nuru and Zala have been helping me with all of my planning and all of my marking as well. So I thought it would only be fair if they also helped me to choose my star of the week. So first, I'm going to pass over to Nuru, and she is going to tell us all who the first star of the week is this week. Oh, they are a bit sleepy. I'm going to bribe them with a treat. Nuru! Do you want a sweetie? Do you want a sweetie? Come here. Good girl. What's this? It says open from Nuru. Okay, let's see. Let's see who Nuru's star of the week is. It is... Lovely! What lovely handwriting, Nuru, as well. So Lovely is my star of the week this week for all of her amazing work that she's been doing on Edmodo. Some of you might not recognise this name because she's a new pupil to 3A, but she has been so dedicated to her learning over the past couple of weeks, and I don't think that she's missed a single assignment. She has been amazing. This week, I loved her ICT PowerPoint on
It was all about her, so I got to learn a bit more about Lovely and her family. She did some lovely artwork as well about her previous school, and also she got full marks in her maths quiz. So she has been amazing. So well done, Lovely. Okay, I'm now going to get another treat and see if Zala has got a star of the week for me. Zala, do you want a sweetie? Do you want a sweetie? No. Come on, what's this? What's this? What's this? What's this? Are you gonna sit for me? You gonna sit? Good girl, not you, Nuri, you've already had yours. Wow. This says, open from Zala. Oh, you're so good. Open from Zala. So let's see who Zala's star of the week is. Zala star of the week is Glorianne. So well done, Glorianne. You have been chosen by Zala because the past couple of weeks you have been submitting some fantastic work on Edmodo. You've also done some lovely artwork this week, telling me all about your favourite memories of year three and how you miss your friends and your teachers, which was really nice to see. You've done all your quizzes this week, and you also did some lovely science work yesterday on, oh, what's that noise? Banana trees in the rainforest. So well done to Glorianne. So I'm gonna say bye from the pups. Say bye, Zala. Bye. Bye, Nuru. Okay. And bye from me. Hope you all have a lovely, lovely summer. I can't wait to see you all back in August when 3A, you will be year four. I cannot believe it. Well done to all of you the past couple of weeks for all the amazing work that you've been doing. I've been so impressed. You should be so proud of yourselves. And I will see you all soon. Bye.
Good afternoon. Hello, Foje. Well, our time in year four has come to an end. Just like that. But before I go further, I want to recognize one last people of the week. And this people is Unaisa. Well done, Unaisa. I have chosen you today and this week because I have seen you work very hard in all your tasks. I have seen you try to do your best. Other than that, I know that apart from the assigned tasks that we give you, you've been doing a lot of work, a lot of extra work on IXL. And recently you were awarded a gold certificate for the excellent work you did in math. This is after working on that site for over 15 hours in 10 days. And having solved over 1,800 questions. This is impressive. And I'm told that as a result of all the work you're doing on that site, you've been able to acquire over 181 new skills. This is impressive. This is commendable. Congratulations, Unaisa, on what you're doing. I also know you're doing some other work in science and I think English and history. I look forward to getting very good reports from you. Well done. Keep it up. And 4J, like I said, our time is up. I've been proud to be your teacher this year. You are wonderful people, like I said earlier in my letter. And as you move on to year five, I know you're going to make me very proud. As you proceed to your holiday, I would like to wish you all the best. Have fun. Take care of yourselves. Keep doing a lot of reading and get ready for your time in year five. Goodbye. Take care.
Well done to everyone who has been a pupil of the week so far. Before I go on to some more videos, I want to talk to you a little bit about reading. As you know, you've been doing incredible reading recently online using our Epic app and the Epic website. You have read over 4,500 books, and there's a good chance we will reach 5,000 books read by Isimilo students before the end of the year. So, I have some news regarding Epic and then a news regarding a challenge. I will start with the Epic news. Unfortunately, it's a little bit of sad news. Next week, Epic stops being a free to use reading app. So Epic, the website and the app very kindly, whilst all these schools around the world were closed, made their website completely free for us to use. And I've been emailing them and I've been asking them really nicely if they could make a school membership for us, but unfortunately it's not possible. So Epic, the company, is a bit like Netflix. So if you watch Netflix at home or have ever seen it, you'll know mummy or daddy has to pay money each month so that you can access it. And Epic works in the same way. So it's quite expensive. It's $8.99 a month for you and your family to access it. So you can ask mummy and daddy if they can sign up for you. But obviously that is quite a lot of money. Keep checking the website and the app though, because there is talk that they are going to put out a free version of the app that might allow you to read some of their books. I'm not quite sure how that will work yet. If I see anything, I will let you know. But keep a lookout on the app to see if you can make that work as well. However, it's not all bad news. You may have seen coming out yesterday, and I snuck a little preview out of it on Wednesday, the Isamilo 2020 Summer Reading Challenge. This is a reading challenge for pupils all the way through primary and secondary school. And there are a number of different challenges on there for you to complete over the summer. It's through reading books, that could be online, that could be books you have. The library is going to be open Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday and Friday, every day during the holiday. So you can come in between 9 a.m. and 3 p.m. and get books and read books in the library and change your books. So you have no excuse for being sat at home bored, because we've got lots of new books in the library that have been donated to us. So come and have a look at them over the summer. Complete the reading challenges. Everybody who completes their reading challenge and returns the sheet to school on their first week back will get a signed certificate. So that was a bit of news about our reading challenge. I'm now going to go back to some videos from your teachers about their pupils of the week. And then we have a very special video message from Miss Linnea that will come at the end of that section. So please watch very carefully and I will see you back at the end of these messages.
Okay, so 4E's star of the week, Edward is going, and his friends are going to tell us who that is.
Come here! Oh, Ed, good boy.
Well done, Edward. Okay, who's Edward chosen this week? Edward. Right? Okay.
Donna?
Come on. No, they're not going to do it.
Yay!
Okay, she's decided not. Oh, look, it's his saying after all. Edward's decided not to cheat anymore. So. Sorry, 4E. Yeah, we tried to have everybody, but Mr. Evans wouldn't let us. So well done to Hussein for consistently submitting work for on Edmodo. And for everybody else, thank you very much for all your hard work this term. And Edward would like to say, well done too. Have a wonderful holiday and we'll see you next year. I'm going to give him a big lick, Edward.
Good afternoon, Year 6. I hope you've had a good week and it's nice to talk to you for one last time before you move up to secondary school next year. Thank you to all of those of you who have continued to send in your work this week. So many of you have decided you want to go to Hawaii for your dream holiday, and I have to say, it's a very good choice. I've done a lot of thinking this week about who I would like to pick for Pupil of the Week, and it's been a very hard choice. And I've been looking back over the whole year as well. And I've come to the conclusion that I am going to pick everyone for Pupil of the Week. You have all worked so hard this year. You worked extremely hard preparing for your exams. You've all made the transition to distance learning very quick and easily, so well done. Have a lovely, relaxing summer holiday and come back in September ready to work hard. Good luck.
Hello everyone, and especially 6M. My Pupil of the Week this week is based on the work that has been done over the last 12 weeks of online learning, and also a little bit over the work that was done when we were in school before, seeing as this is our final Pupil of the Week. So, the person I think who deserves Pupil of the Week is all of you. All of 6M are the Pupils of the Week this week. You have worked so hard, both during these distance learning times, but also as a year six cohort all year. We had incredible house captains, we had incredible helping at sports day. You have been a credit to Isimilo International Primary School, and we wish you well as you move up into secondary school. Well done, 6M. You are all pupils of the week.
Hello everybody in Key Stage 2, and especially 5A. As you can maybe see in the background, I am no longer in Tanzania. I unfortunately had to leave a bit early, so I left Thursday last week. I had a safe flight, a very good flight, and everybody made sure to keep everybody very, very safe. So I am still corona free. I am walking outside because the weather is so nice and there's almost no cars. And this is the tiny village where my parents live, and it's called Esp, A-S-P. There's about 250 people living here, and they have a supermarket, probably the size of U-Turn. So this is a little view of how the start of the little village looks. It's very peaceful, very quiet, and nothing like Mwanza. What I'm trying to tell you now, and what I have to tell you, is that unfortunately I won't be returning to Isimilo next year. I got a job here in Denmark as a teacher, and so I'll start a new life and a new job with new children back home. I will miss you all very much, and I hope that I will be able to come back very soon to visit you. And if not, then you are always more than welcome to come and visit me in Denmark. I wish you all the best, and I know that you are all going to be excellent and amazing at whatever you pursue in the future. I'll miss you all. Goodbye. Bye!
So it is now the time for some singing. We're just going to have two songs in our assembly today, and then I will be returning at the end of the assembly to share with you some information about next year, to talk a little bit about some things that are happening over the summer, and then we will introduce our art gallery. Lots of you sent in amazing artwork, so I'm going to do that to close out our final assembly. So, two songs, sing loud. This is your last time to sing up with your family at home on a Friday afternoon, and then we will return and I will share some information with you. Okay, time to sing.
I see what's happening, yeah. You're face to face with greatness and it's strange. You don't even know how you feel. It's adorable. Well, it's nice to see that humans never change. Open your eyes, let's begin. Yes, it's really me, it's Maui, breathe it in. I know it's a lot, the hair, the bod. When you're staring at a demigod, what can I say except you're welcome for the tides, the sun, the sky. Hey, it's okay, it's okay, you're welcome. I'm just an ordinary demi-guy. Hey, what has two thumbs and pulled up the sky? When you were waddling yay high, this guy. When the nights got cold, who stole you fire from down below? Look at that, yo. Oh, also I lassoed the sun. To stretch your days and bring you fun. Also, I harness the breeze. You're welcome to fill your sails and shake your trees. So what can I say except you're welcome for the islands I pull from the sea. There's no need to pray, it's okay. You're welcome. Ha! I guess it's just my way of being me. Honestly, I
could go on and on. I could explain every natural phenomenon. The tide, the grass, the ground. Oh, that was Maui just messing around. I killed an eel, I buried its guts. Sprouted a tree, now you got coconuts. What's the lesson? What is the takeaway? Don't mess with Maui when he's on a breakaway. And the tapestry here in my skin is a map of the victories I win. Look where I've been, I make everything happen. Look at that king and the Maui just take it.
A big noise playing in the street. Gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace. Kicking your can all over the place. Singing,
We will rock you. We will rock you.
Buddy, you're a young man, hard man, shouting in the street. Gonna take on the world someday. You got blood on your face, a big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place.
We will rock you.
Sing it!
We will rock you.
Buddy, you're an old man, poor man, pleading with your eyes. Gonna make you zombie someday. You got mud on your face, big disgrace. Somebody better put your bag into your place.
We will rock you.
Sing it.
We will rock you.
Everybody,
we will rock you. We will rock you.
All right.
So, I promised I would give you some information on next year. The good news is, unless I have already sat with you or your parents, you will all be moving up to your new classes and year groups next year. So a few people had messaged me a little bit worried because they didn't know what was happening. So don't worry, you will be moving up to your new year group. When you start, your first day back is Monday, the 31st of August. When you come in on that day, you will find out your new classroom, your new teacher, and your new classes. That will all happen on that first day back. Obviously, we normally have a changeover day where you go meet your new teacher and you see your new room. Obviously, that couldn't happen this time. So, all of you in years 3, 4, and 5, you will come in and we'll all sit on the steps in the morning, and then we will introduce your classes and your teachers, and you'll get to go away and meet your new teacher and things like that. Year 6, you obviously had a video from Miss Weston this week. Yours is a little bit different because you are out of here and you're going to be secondary pupils next year. So you'll get lots of information because yours is a little bit different. So what I wanted to say was, don't worry, you'll find out your new classes when you come back on the 31st of August. Monday, the 31st of August. So it's even more important than usual that you don't miss that first day, because otherwise you won't know which class you're in and you won't know who your new teacher is. So make sure everyone, turn to the person sat with you at home, tell them 31st of August, because it is a little bit earlier than we normally come back. So I will see you all then. Other announcements. Keep a lookout. There is some news coming about some activities that are going to be running at school over the holidays. I can't tell you too much more at the moment. They are being finalised this weekend. Next week, your parents have all been invited to a meeting, and in that meeting with me and Miss Williams, we will talk about some activities happening at school, and then we will send out the information to you guys as well to keep you entertained over the summer. I think you will be very happy. Over the summer, we are allowed to have children back into school. The government are allowing us to have children into school, so you'll be able to do some fun things over the summer. There are some clubs we're going to be running, so keep a lookout for those. Everybody else, I will see you on August the 31st when we return to school. Make sure you are reading over the summer. Make sure you're doing some maths practice, some times tables practice. Maybe keep a diary of things you're up to keep practicing your reading. Write a weekly story will help your story writing, so when you return in the new year, you hit the ground running. And one more announcement. You can probably tell I keep cutting between videos and the time has suddenly jumped forward a few hours. But I wanted to jump into this part of assembly here to tell you about a special event Miss Reynolds is arranging. As well as seeing our art gallery online at the end of this assembly, we are going to be having an art show in school. Keep a lookout for a poster Miss Reynolds will share on Edmodo today. You may have seen it already. It may come up shortly after this assembly, but make sure you're having a look. Miss Reynolds will share it. It is all about an art show we're going to be putting on when you return to school at the end of August. So keep a lookout for that. And I'm going to cut back out and cut back to assembly. So as promised, to end our final ever online assembly, we are going to take a visit to the Isimilo International Art Gallery. So I'm going to say goodbye, have a lovely summer. I look forward to seeing all of you back in school on August 31st. And let's go over to the Isimilo Art Gallery.
This is my poem about coronavirus. Colossal, original, racing, not nice, antibacterial, virtual time, interesting, ruined my goodbyes, unbelievably fast and sad time, coronavirus.
One night to be confused, one night to speed up truth. We had a promise made, four hands and then away. Both under influence, we had divine sin. To know what to say, mind is a razor blade. To call for hands of above, to lead. Night of magic rush, the start a simple touch. One night to push and scream, and then relief. 10 days of perfect tunes, the colors red and blue. We had a promise made, we were in love. To call for hands of above, to lean on. Awake with false teeth, sharing different hearts.